beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep. And God said, let there be light. And there was light. On the second day, God separated the waters to form the seas and the sky. On the third day, God created the land with trees and plants and fruits.
Will we ever see land again?
Of course we will. The next day, he put the sun, the moon, and stars in the heavens. And on the fifth day, all the creatures of the sea and of the air. And on the sixth day, all the creatures of the ground. And then he made us to live in paradise. Until Adam and Eve disobeyed God and ate the forbidden fruit. And with one choice, they learned both good and evil. Since then, since Cain killed Abel, God has seen too much evil in human hearts. Wrong choices, wrong decisions. That's why this is happening. Our Creator decided to cleanse the earth. God warned me. He told me to build a boat. A boat to save our family and all the animals. Every other living creature would die. Seventh day, God rested.
Floodwaters engulf the world. There is a new beginning for Noah's descendants and a chance to restore the relationship between God and humanity. This is the Bible.
Lord! It has begun.
What are we gonna do?
Change the world.
A nation and a people find faith in an all-powerful creator.
You only have one father, and he is in heaven. You only have one teacher, and he is the Christ.
Their story helps define who we are.
Your hunger for righteousness.
We
will be filled through me.
The choices we make.
Whoever believes in me shall never die.
How we live.
Blessed are the poor, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
How we love.
Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth.
How we struggle and overcome.
There will be no more death, or mourning, or crying, or pain. I am coming soon.
Before billions can believe in him, one man must hear God's voice and have the faith to follow.
Abraham, leave your home and go to the land I will give to you and your offspring. I will bless you. I will make you a father of many nations, with descendants as numerous as the stars. All the peoples on earth will be blessed through you.
Sarah, God has spoken to me. Come with me.
Lot, my nephew, walk with us.
Abraham?
God has spoken to me.
He will lead us to a new home.
But we have a home. A good home.
Away from the city, to a new land. For our children.
But you have no children. You can never have children.
But we will. He has promised descendants as numerous as the stars.
He spoke to me.
And Lot, you're with me?
He will lead us to a land of wonder.
No.
Driven by the belief that he will father a great nation, Abraham leads his small tribe to the land promised to him by God.
Abraham, what we decided.
What's going on? His men are trying to take our pasture.
God gave us this land to share.
Then he should have given us more of it. Tell him.
Abraham, there just isn't enough land. There are too many of us.
The Lord will provide. Have faith.
In a God we cannot see.
It's time we go our separate ways.
No. No, we must stay together.
Stay and starve. Stay and watch our men kill each other over a blade of grass.
Uncle. We're leaving.
Very well. Where do you want to go?
To the greener pasture just closer to Sodom.
Sodom? They are dangerous lands.
No children of his own. Abraham's nephew Lot is the closest thing he has to a son.
How can I lead a people when I can't even lead my own family?
What happened?
We didn't stand a chance. There were so many of them.
And Lot?
Alive. But taken prisoner.
Help him!
Here. Take my hand. Lean on me.
Aspen. Tend to him.
We have some trained men.
Abraham, you are not Sanchez.
I told them to trust in God. I made Lot come with us.
And then they left us. They had their pick of the land. It was their choice.
They are family.
We have to help them.
God will take care of us.
Lot. Oh, Lot.
So few of us against so many. God is with us.
Abraham. We're carrying on to Sodom.
Yes.
It's steady, Ishmael.
Fire!
my boy.
My boy. Your boy.
Get with your mother. Welcome, Lord. Please, join me. Bring water. Prepare food for our visitors.
Yes, Master.
Have you traveled far?
Yes, a long way. Abraham, where is your wife?
In there.
Next year, Sarah will have a son. Why do you laugh? You did. And when you have a son, you will name him Isaac, which means laughter.
Thank you for your hospitality. We must go.
Can I help you on your way? Where are you going?
The fate of Sodom.
Sodom has become corrupt. A city of sin.
But my nephew Lot lives there. He has a family.
The outcry against Sodom is great. Its sins are very grave.
You're going to destroy it. The whole city.
What if there were 50 good people in Sodom? Would they suffer the same fate as the wicked?
Please, help us!
We will test them. If my angels find 50 righteous people in Sodom, I will spare the whole city.
Please, help us. Help us.
Fewer.
30. 20.
righteous men in Sodom. Would you not save them?
Lot, what are you doing? Who are these people?
They need our help. I'll do what I can for you.
Even if I find only 10, I will save the whole city.
This way!
Hurry!
Wife is turned into a pillar of salt for disobeying God. Lot and his daughters flee to the mountains, never to see Abraham again.
Thank you.
is she?
Your bread. Eat your food, Ishmael.
Ishmael.
Good.
Thinks her boy is going to inherit what rightfully belongs to Isaac.
What do you mean?
Who is to be the first of all our tribe, Abraham? The first star of all those stars in the heavens. Our son. Or hers.
Sarah.
Abraham. Abraham. You decide. Be brave.
Assured by God that they will survive, Abraham sends Hagar and Ishmael into the wilderness.
Make you some breakfast, Isaac.
After years of struggle, Abraham has learned that to be chosen by God is a blessing and a test. He must prove his faith again and again.
When you have children of your own, you want to grow up as big and Abraham? What's the matter?
God wants to sacrifice. My boy, come with me.
Abraham has passed the ultimate test. He will become the father of God's nation. Now it's up to Isaac. He will have a son called Jacob. God will rename him Israel. The promise of descendants as numerous as the stars is coming true. But soon, famine forces the Israelites far from the promised land, to Egypt. Here they are enslaved by Pharaoh. Over the next 400 years, Abraham and God become a distant memory. All his people reduced to beasts of burden. Except one.
Moses. You're not going to fight again.
I can't refuse. He's Pharaoh's son, Mother.
The fighting between them has to stop.
Moses doesn't want a fight. It's your son who forces him into it. And keeps losing.
You may be my sister's favorite, but I will be Pharaoh.
I will be God!
Please.
Fight me! I order you!
Moses! Enough!
He needs to learn his place!
You were the one that started!
I will be Pharaoh!
Then you'd better start behaving like one.
This is your fault. You should never have let her keep him.
Silence!
You're not one of us!
Silence, I said!
What's he talking about?
You'd better tell him now. You! Come with me!
Mother, tell me what? What?!
Moses. I love you like a son. But you're not my blood. You're born a slave. Father kills so many children. He feared a rebellion. Your people were too many.
My people.
I saved you. Your people are out there, Moses. Our slaves. The Israelites. You had a brother, Aaron, and a sister, Miriam. But they are not like us. They worship the God of Abraham, and he has deserted them.
My lord, the amulet of Moses. Shall we hunt him down?
No. Let him go. He's no threat now.
Welcome to your new life, Moses! You are nothing now!
Nothing.